Called a kavatwam. It's in ragam, gauli, thalam adi. A kavatwam is a traditional prayer to Lord Kartikeya, the warrior son of Lord Shiva and goddess Parvati. The dancer describes the majesty of Lord Kartikeya seated on his peacock. Lord Kartikeya destroys worries and protects his devotees against all evil.
Tak kudu dikudu dari kita, tak kudu dikudu dari kita. 2002, Rangeela 2016! I'm Neil Shinnuck, and I'm honored to be your host tonight. But for a show this big, there's no way I'd want MTV all by myself. So please welcome my co-host of the night, Mr. Aditya Shah!
But first, yo, can I talk to you privately for a second?
Dude, the show's live. Whatever you have to say, say it right here in front of everyone else.
Well, I can't MC tonight.
Wait, what?
Yeah, my parents are kind of making me study for AP exams.
Wait, Lydia, AP exam ended 2 weeks ago.
Next year, exams.
What do you mean?
Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm round of applause for my friend, Christian Sherwin!
Hi everyone! Aditya, can I talk to you privately for a second?
Nah, I'd rather do it out here with all the witches.
So let me get this straight. First off, is your cultural show, right? A show that comes once a year to Hightstown. You went out and found the whitest kid in the school.
I don't see a problem with that.
Well, you're gonna have a major problem if this kid doesn't do a good job tonight.
Nah, don't worry. This kid is an honorary agent. He's just like one of us.
Oh man, that's my sixth iPhone this week.
Just like one of us, right? Anyway, let's get this party started. So, can we have on our stage our main skit writer, Mr. Ben Hussaini?
Yes and no. We had a skit, but it turns out there was like this big puja on like Edison, and the entire skit cast just migrated.
The show ain't even started yet, it's already falling apart.
Just like my GPA.
See, here's the
point. You know what? I can't do it. Manny, just do something.
I gotta go check up on you. Looks like you're on your own time.
Good luck, Manny.
Thank you. Alright, okay. Well, I don't have a story prepared for you tonight, unfortunately. But, I think I can make one up on the spot. Now, I can't promise a Bollywood blockbuster epic, but who knows? Maybe I'll have something with a little bit of meaning to it. We might even see a dance number or two.
Did you hear? Mr. Khanna's son only got a 94.2 on his board exam. He didn't get full marks like my book. What a disappointment. What other juicy gossip have you heard? Really? Achha! Ranbir broke up with Deepika?
Wait, you mean to say that Deepika Padukone is now a single lady?
Hey, back your face. She'll never make rotis as round as I do. Okay, Urmila, we'll chat at our kitty party later. I've got some cleaning to do. Arey, bache! Niche aao! Dinner's ready! Jaldi!
Mom! Dinner isn't even ready! Why do you always do this?
Hey, you're only watching TV anyway.
Mom, we were actually studying?
I doubt it. After seeing your bar exam scores, I don't think you've studied in the past 10 years. Dad! I got a 92% on that last exam.
92? Wow! Bishop! Mr. Khanna's son got 94.6. Where did those 8 points go?
Yeah, but Mr. Khanna's son is a straight loser. He takes some guru's pills that he thinks make him smarter, and then farts 24/7.
Hey! Don't compare yourself to other kids! I don't care what other kids are doing in the past time!
I mean, I got a 96 on my last.
Okay, let's not get cocky. What?
Okay, enough with your useless nonsense. We actually have some very important news. Come, sit, sit.
We've been meaning to tell you this for a really long time now. It turns out that your father...
We're moving!
Rich! You said it pretty to them gently.
Oh, right.
Take two.
But, we're going to begin a new chapter of our lives in the land of opportunity.
Opportunity? That means we're moving to Goa. Oh, I have to get ready.
What? We're moving to Goa? But why? All we do there is, like, party on the beach.
No, you duffer. The land of opportunity is the universal reference of the United States. Finally, my extensive knowledge of Hollywood will pay off. George Clooney, Selena Gomez, Ashton Kutcher, I know it all.
Yes, yes, Sonia. You and your brothers can continue your studies in Africa.
This is a great way for you to make something of your currently useless life. We expect proper exam scores from now on.
Full 100 on American set.
Who the hell did you get the door at this bloody hour?
Hey, what's up, buddy?
Hey, Marco. Hi, Auntie. What brings you guys here?
Oh, you know, just came to say hi and check in on our favorite neighbors. What's going on, guys?
Well, darling sir, the truth is we will not be your neighbors much longer because we are moving to America!
Oh, my. We have been in this world.
Our
TV
is broken and we need to watch
iPhone.
Yes, quickly.
They've
already started.
Okay, you guys go watch your shows. I'll clean like I always do.
Hey, I heard Deepika is single now.
Oh, here she is.
Our three main characters, Deepa, Kabir, and Sonia, were headed to America with their FOB parents. Now, adjusting to a new environment is always a little bit of a shock. So let's see how our heroes are faring in the most dangerous and unforgiving places of all, high school.
Does everyone have everything? Backpacks, pencils, tiffins? I think Mommy packed us an extra nashta for today.
Oh, she did. She gave me the last packet of fruit grade.
Yeah, but dude, there's a Hyderabadi hangama fruit grade. What's up with that?
Oh, those are the worst. Oh.
Yo, looks like we got some noobs fresh off the boat.
Hey guys, what's up?
Look at these kids walking in with some barbecue lemons.
Hey, you think we look like we came off a boat? You guys look like you're about to go on a boat. You little spoiled tourist looking, hamburger chewing, 2+2 not know what it is. Your mom probably still feeds you milk at night.
Alright guys, everyone calm down. Let's take an American chill pill.
Okay guys, let's relax here. Yeah, Nika, teach the newbie some respect.
Guys, you'll learn to one's at a cool crew, and one's at art. Clearly, the meetup here is not.
But, Gordon is much better. I heard you guys do it so often that you didn't even get a chance of being in the cool crew.
Mia, that's not how you introduce someone. Besides, you don't even want to be part of that cult.
All of you is gas themselves by insulting each other anyway.
Well, it's really nice to meet you guys. I'm Deepa. That is my overstudious sister, Sonia. And here's my brother,
Kabir.
He also has trouble with bladder control.
Deepa, you better sleep with one eye open.
Don't worry, Kabir. Some of us are just born with certain illnesses.
Dude, that's so true.
Alright, listen up. I'm your substitute teacher, Mr. Rogers. I've taught in the inner city for 20 years, so don't even think about messing with you. Y'all get what I'm saying?
Yo, this guy seems like that weirdo back home. Mr. Dubin?
Oh, yes. But not Mr. Dubin. The Mr. the Dubin.
Ah, yes. The Mr. the Dubin. As you would say, this man is the man, the boy.
No. Not boy.
Boy. Ah, yes. He's the man, the boy. He's in true need of the psychiatrist, in my opinion.
Okay, quiet down. Roll call here. John?
Here.
Namita?
Here.
Mira?
Here.
Farhan Akhtar?
Here.
Smith?
Here.
Sasa Bubicic?
Here.
Smitty Reverend Hannah Jensen?
Here.
Yindrik Dovra?
Here.
Jack Mary's Tatarichiks?
Here.
That's what we were called the Matola de Rosa Ramirez? Deepak?
It's Deepa. I'm here.
Kabir?
Oh, man. It's Kabir. I'm here.
You know, I never understood. How can you pronounce such a difficult name like Smitty Roman Jagger Jetson, but not a nice, simple name like Deepak or Kabir? Anyways.
Okay, I don't know how to say this one, but I'm gonna try.
Sonia?
Anyways, let's get started with our lesson today. Today we're going to learn about antiderivatives.
Antiderivatives? We learned that in the third standard. Hey man, that's not cool.
Hey, quiet in the back over there.
Man, stop. That's not cool.
If I got to tell you one more time, I'm going to be mad. Hey, pick up your trash. This ain't no Detroit.
Bruh, that's it.
Excuse me! It's your first day, you're talking in my class, making a mess and bullying my students? Hell nah, do you know what this means?
Yeah, I'm sorry. Good memories, am I right, parents?
What the hell? That's how things work around here? Y'all are a bunch of guy sponsors to learn a properly after school.
Guys, I've heard about this guidance department.
Have?
It's not fun.
Well, at least they didn't get hit in the end, right? I mean, this Mr. Rogers.
Excuse kind of me?
A loose cannon. And the guidance department can't be that bad, right? I have a feeling this is going to get worse before it gets better.
If you're going to be a hype host tonight, the first thing you have to learn is how to hype up the crowd.
Oh, please, Neil, I already know how to hype up a crowd. One time at one of my family barbecues, I got an entire crowd to cheer me on.
Really? Wow, well, what did you do?
I ate 50 hot dogs in 10 minutes, and I only barked twice.
Christian, I don't think that's going to work in this case, because, like, half the crowd is like,
well, you're gonna be a thought to hype up this kind of crowd.
Yeah, okay, so when you wanna hype up a crowd, right? You wanna say something that the audience feels passionate about. Something that they can relate to.
Okay, I got this. Who else watches Duck Dynasty every Sunday night, am I right? No, Christian.
Something they relate to, not yourself.
Okay, I got this one. Who agrees that Abby Shakes is better than Amit Dabi?
No one thinks that they would see that. Okay, look. If you want to say something that'll get the whole crowd rallied up, especially in this kind of environment, you have to talk about something they take a lot of pride in, like their roots. For example, you might be South Indians in the house tonight. Yeah! Two of my eligible friends in the back. I said, you might have any South Indians in the house tonight. Yeah! All right. I gotta go the opposite. You might be North Indian somewhere.
Okay, then what did you do? I think he got the day.
Sorry about that. It just took me a while to recover from that yelling mat that I got from Mr. Rogers. He's a character. Anyways, we have our three students exiled from their math class on their way to meet the dreaded guidance counselor. I wonder how that's going to be. Mr. Joseph, you have three students sent here for bad behavior.
Ah, yes. People needing spiritual guidance. And at 10:37, just as the numbers align, this is very auspicious indeed. Send them in, send them in. Welcome, welcome. I am the school guidance counselor, the great Prem Jyotish. So tell me, children, what troubles are you having in the night?
Sir, the students here keep trying to pick fights with us. I mean, we were just sitting there in the maths class.
Ah, yes, the maths. Yes, yes, the study of numerology is very important to your cosmic vibration.
Going to go.
No. Nonsense. Everybody has troubles that only astrology and numerology can fix. Stars told me that I would be giving guidance to youngerlings today.
Sir, you're a guidance counselor. Your job is to literally give guidance to young people.
That's beside the point. So the stars, the alignments of the planets, they all give me insight into the ways of the world, and I use that insight to guide my pupils in the right direction. So children, tell me about your lives.
Well, Mr. Jyotish, it all started when we were living in India, and then we joined school, and then we got bad grades, and then our parents yelled at us, and then our dad says we're moving, and I think we're moving to go, but then we're not moving to go, and then we come to America, then we go to a math class, and students are mean, the teacher doesn't even know how to punish the students, he sends us to a guidance counselor, and now we're in a room with a man named Prem Jyotish.
Relax, disciple! Your cosmic energies are overflowing! I just want to know how are you doing in this new school?
Well, we are third eye.
Well, we're trying to adapt to the new environment, sir. This is all kind of like a culture shock.
Ah, yes. The alignment of the moon and the Mars have told me that something of this sort will occur. In fact, Venus is in the sky today. It signifies that there will be a big change in your life. You will find who you are in this life and achieve the happiness and the success.
Sir? Who are you talking to?
This makes no sense.
Hey! Of course it does! The stars and the numbers define the ways of the world, and I use them to show me the truth.
You mean like the truth
that
you just told me.
Child, the truth was revealed to me long ago when I first began my spiritual journey, learning the art of astrology and numerology.
Art? What art? How dare you call yourself a guidance counselor when you pretend to use numbers and stars and pretend to know what the universe wants? You and your whole practice are more fake than Kachina Pasadiki.
Oh man, Mr. Jyotish, did your planets and stars tell you this was gonna happen? We're out.
This whole thing is a scam, isn't it?
Shh. Hi all, I am the great Prem Jyotish. With positive energy and the right guidance, you can achieve happiness and success in life. I can be your spiritual guide through this long and enlightening journey. With my extensive knowledge of astrology and numerology, I can do help to you. So if you want my guidance, simply make a call to my secretary, simply make a call to my office, and book an appointment with my secretary. So some of my assistants are handing out the number right now. But in case you don't get it...
All right, that's enough. This is my story.
718-891-6161, come on, today!
Sorry about that. MCs, you can take over now, please.
So, Neil, what's the deal with this Fran Jyotish guy? Why is he so famous in the first place?
Good question, Christian. You see, Fran Jyotish has been on ZTV commercials since 2005. That's even before, like, the Ayo, pasta again! He claims that the stars and the numbers, they have the answers to all of life's problems. But everyone knows he's just a dating fraud.
Can you use the stars and numbers to fix all my problems? Can you help me get rid of this rash on my back?
Ew, no. You don't listen to anything I say, dude.
What's that?
At least you guys listen to me. So now it's time for my favorite part of the show.
But first, here's the fashion show.
Thank you. really want. Cause y'all got a really big team, and they need some really big rings. They need some really nice things. Better be coming with no strings. Better be coming with no strings. We need some really nice things. We need some really big rings. I got a really big team. I got a really big team. They need some really big rings. They need some really nice things. Better be coming with no strings. Better be coming with no strings. We need some really nice things. We need some really big rings. I got a really big team.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I just stole a Mary Dean?
Just
So the next chapter of our story is where things get really entertaining. Deepak, Kabir, and Sonia have already left their home in India. They've gotten kicked out of math class for being disruptive. And they've met with the mysterious friend Jyotish, that weirdo that tried to steal my spotlight. I wonder what kind of challenges they'll face when they try to mix with kids their own age at lunch.
Dude, honestly, this place confuses me. You have a group of really weird students, and you have a guidance counselor that doesn't even guide.
Watching Ned C Classified School Survival Guide did not prepare me for this.
Guys, don't worry. We've been through this much of the day. I'm sure we'll be fine. Give it some time.
Forget school. What's trending? I heard that Kanye just released The Life of Parthu. Is this hip-hop happening music?
Oh, Sonia. It's Pablo, not Parthu, and it's hip-hop music, not hip-hop happening.
Oh, well, same to same. I just finished binge-watching House of Cards, in which Lightning McCain totally won the race.
Oh no, we have a lot to teach you.
Yo, the cafeteria service bricks with cheese on them? I called it pizza.
Dude, these cookies look like asada from Hightstown.
Guys, rule number one, never buy the lunch here. That's a mistake you can only make once.
Yo, how was your day after you got roasted by Mr. Rogers?
Well, we went to see the great friend Joseph, master of the guidance department. He kept trying to enlighten us about astrology and numerology.
I love that guy.
He is the GOAT.
GOAT? Like that GOAT? Yeah, that guy's the realest. He helped me deal with the fact that my parents bought me an Acura instead of an Audi.
Yeah, like, I remember once, I was having trouble seeing inside my fridge, right? Because all the food was blocking the light. But then friend enlightened me, I was able to see again. My actual charger would have reached my bed. Come show me to the world before my charges. He really is divine being.
Forgetting that. Sonia, Deepak, look, mom packed the kitchen.
No.
The E-E-E
double hockey stick
is bad. PhDs? OMG. What is that stench coming from your rip-off Cheetos? I mean, I don't like this flavor either, but it doesn't smell that bad, man.
Yeah, guys.
At least I know what I'm eating. Better than your hot dogs.
Yeah, guys, let them live. They've been in this country for less than a day. Let them eat.
You're only defending him because you've been struggling with that for the past 4 years.
Hey, they've already had a wrong day. No reason to make it worse for them.
And you're one to talk. Your cologne smells like a dying pig every time about smells.
Hey, Farm, shut up. Remember that unfortunate day you had at middle school when you ripped your pants?
I was bending over to pick up my limited edition Power Rangers action figure. Let me live!
Don't worry about that. You get used to a daily dose of bad insults. Okay, well, let's start soon.
Besides, our authentic food is the best smells of life.
Dude, that's so true, man.
What they call stench, we call aroma.
That's true. We're stench buddies, am I right?
Yeah, we are amazing stench buddies. I love you.
Can't believe they don't like our food, though.
Not just our food, they don't like our clothes or our dough.
Yeah, I can't come to school just to insult them.
Well, there's only one way that we can become accepted by their group. We're going to have to become more like them.
That, but they're almost as fraudulent as that brain Jyotish.
But clearly, that's the norm around here, Kabir. We can't
came to this new place and now we have to adapt ourselves to this environment. Clearly our style doesn't pass around here. Let's just see what their interpretation of cool is and see where that gets us.
Yeah, let's start thinking about what each of us can do. But for now, let's just go class.
Oh, I forgot that issue.
I was afraid something like that would happen. I didn't think the insults were gonna go that far. I hope they don't end up doing anything they regret, like eating those heather bodies and gamma corpore.
Oh,
Who wants a free t-shirt?
Yeah.
keep our heads above the water. Okay, but there's more important news regarding our school's football team. The Leones will be versing Huntington in the semifinals next week. And Mr. Johnson, I'd like to congratulate your son, Bobby, for getting MVP for his outstanding performance as a wide receiver.
Bobby had better fingers. Meanwhile, my son's taking 1380 classes at once. Yeah, well, my son got an internship at NASA. Oh. My daughter discovered a protein and named it after me.
My son got a letter of recommendation from Obama.
Oh yeah? Well, my son is studying abroad next semester. In Mars!
Do you know what just happened? You just got played. Okay, so let's work together. That's a fair meeting.
Fair meeting? I thought this was an interview.
What the bloody hell is this?
Ramesh, this is useless. Let's go home.
Let's go.
So after the failed coffee with the principal, Hafsan Ramesh decided to return home. And they know just a little bit more about what kind of children go to their kids' school.
I hope our kids don't become like that.
Hey, yo, what's good, Pops?
Pops? Who is this Pops? A Pops are dumped in your face!
And what is this you're wearing? Did they run out of fabric at the store or what?
Mom, this is a style. Don't be such a hater. Appreciate my swag. All the girls at school said it looks totally on me.
On me?
And who got you these things around your neck?
The headphones, Zab. My friend lent them to me. They're Beats by Dre.
Oh, Beats by Dre. Okay. I'll give you Beats by the Bay.
You guys have changed so much. Do you even remember how to speak your own language?
Of course we do. Sonia, use namaste in a sentence.
So my friend asked me if I wanted to go out last night, but I had way too much homework. So I was like, namaste at home tonight.
This is such a disappointment.
How much worse can this get? Wait, where's Kabir?
Who is that orange-faced man on your shirt?
No!
This is one of the most trending shirts on the market right now. My friend said wearing it would make me super noticeable.
Make America great again? What the hell does that mean?
Kabir!
Sonia, who is that on his shirt?
Oh, he's no one. He's just a reality TV star. He's really popular at school because he's known for his jokes.
This is you.
I don't want to hear any more of this. You need to get real pants. You need a real shirt. Otherwise, Deepak won't be the only one getting pizza around here.
See what I mean? Roasted and toasted. Ladies and gentlemen, we have now reached the turning point in our story. The parents are completely confused by the workings of their children's school and the new attitudes that they've adopted at home. Meanwhile, the kids are struggling to find an identity that's compatible with both the school environment and their home environment. The story is getting juicier, but first I'm going to need some ice cold mango lassi, so I'll hand it off to the MCs. Take it away!
Favorite thing is calling the police on my neighbors when the dog barks.
I agree.
I have one half Greek, one third Armenian, 2/12 Yiddish, and 1/64 Cherokee.
Oh my god.
Let me take you back, please. Is now it's time for the junior dance.
Thank you.
I don't know, I haven't seen them all day. I hope they didn't get lost. Let's sit down.
Boy, y'all gotta be the coolest cats in town.
Hold your eyes.
Be gentle. Hear the sound of rehearsal. Become wise to him.
Wow, this really is peaceful.
Yeah. If you want to get even more advanced, I suggest you add like the wrist thing. See? Peaceful, right? Well, I guess it's time. There's one major expression you have to learn now.
Oh, show me, I thought we're friends.
No, we are friends. See, that was an expression. Because Indian parents are always just being scared of kids, even though they never actually win.
Really? My mama just sent me my room.
Send me your room. Place your safety there. Anyway, so I think it's time to see what the skit guys like now, right?
Yeah.
Alright.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're nearing the end of our story. This is the moment you've all been waiting for, so strap in. You do not want to miss this. The kids are finally going to have to decide which culture they want to be a part of. Wait, I think someone's coming. Guys, but dancing's actually pretty fun.
Oh, what do you think this is? A Bollywood movie? Autobots, roll out.
Boys, I really don't want to miss this dance. Actually, that's the best part of the party. You gotta stay here.
No one should be pushed to hold me.
Definitely. All right, man. Remember when I told you? told you that dancing is really important in our culture? Mm-hmm. Well, now it's time to show us what you know. So DJ, drop that beat!
Do you have one?